November is Families Stories Month. Since the holidays are here, families get together and share what's been going on in their lives. Did you know what your relatives share is more than a story? This is what Blanca Cobb, who has a master's in psychology, and I are talking about today. So, Blanca, why are stories that grandparents, aunts, and uncles share important?
Family stories are really important because not only do they tell you about traditions and values and just fun facts about your family that makes your family unique, a lot of times your family members are sharing stories that reveal hints about what they've been through, what they've overcome, and their personality. And that can really help you see your family member in different, from a different perspective. Maybe you didn't realize what your grandmother had to go through in order to vote or in order to have a home or whatever the situation is. So you really you can really see the grit and perseverance and drive from a lot of family members when they share their stories.
But we always have that one relative, right, that shares the same story every holiday. But what should you get from that?
Yes. And it's quite funny because it can be the running joke in the family, right? If that one family member tells that same story every holiday. But you have to ask yourself, why does this person share that same story with the same details? What is it about this story? So instead of rolling your eyes and laughing it off, because a lot of families will do that in good fun, it's dig a little deeper, ask some questions. Why is this important to you? Help me understand. You know, Uncle Charlie, you tell the same story every holiday and it's very fascinating, but I want to know a little more about it. What is so appealing about it? What can I learn? What are you trying to share? And a lot of times they will just brighten up because you're taking an interest and they're going to share more, and they probably will go in a direction you didn't even realize in terms of what they're revealing to you.
Yeah, they'll definitely appreciate it. So are there any body language signs that lets us know that a particular story is meaningful for someone?
Oh, yes. If you pay attention to somebody's body language, you will definitely get an indication that their particular parts of a story are significant and meaningful to them. So let me give you a couple of examples. Sometimes when someone is talking, they will pause. And they will pause to reflect on what they're saying. Or maybe they get lost in thought because it generates some memories for them or some emotion. So they might break eye contact and look away. And just pay attention to their eyes and see if you see some eyelid fluttering. And if you see some eyelid fluttering, that lets you know that there's some excitement there, that, you know, there's some emotion. And perhaps it could also be some stress. Pay attention to the changes in their eyes, like their eye movement or even the furrowing of the eyebrows. Also voice changes. So when you notice these behavioral changes or body language changes, that is a cue for you that something emotional happened. And emotional doesn't necessarily mean something bad. It could be emotional excitement. But that is a point for you to say, wait, Uncle Charlie, let me ask you something about this. Because you notice that change in their behavior, their body language, dig a little deeper, ask some questions, but ask open-ended questions because you want them to share more. And it will be amazing what you really learn from your family, not only about them and their values, but the traditions and the uniqueness of your family. And that's something that we pass on through stories by generation.
And it's so important because you never know when you're going to lose that family member. And so just to have those stories to hold on to, and it means a lot to them. Blanca, thank you so much for sharing this with us.
You know, I think this is so important on a lot of different fronts. All of my kids, especially when they were young, I got one that's still young, but the rest of them, when they were little, they would all ask me, they say, tell me something about when you were little. Aww. And when they say that, you know, then I'm pretty much out of stories. You know, I've only have a few to tell them, but they love that. And I think that's kind of a bonding thing.
Yeah, I love talking to my grandparents. I just learned so much from them. They have great advice about life, relationships, and it just really makes me appreciate the things that I have and the opportunities that I have. My grandparents instilled in me hard work and the value of a real education.
Yeah, one thing I do love about going home for the holidays is being able to see my family, because I don't get to see my grandparents often, and they don't always see me on air because they're not good with technology. And so when my grandma, whenever I go home, she always reflects back to when I was younger, when I was that one person in the family as a little girl, always wanting to speak on the microphone, always wanting to just go out when we're in the community and ask somebody questions. I was always that little kid that wanted to talk to people, and she says, look where you are now, Mo. And so I just love talking to my grandparents because they remind me of the childhood child who I was, and now I look at myself today. So it's kind of like a great look back moment when I have conversations with them.
Yeah, I know. I really resonated with what Blanca was talking about, because I only have one grandparent left, and I cherish all the memories that I have with my grandparents, and just hearing their stories of their childhood and how times have changed, and just, I know that's something that I will hold on to forever, and I'm going to pass down to my daughter, and hopefully she'll pass down to her family and her kids.
And I think the older we get, the more we want to ask those questions of them. So do it while you still can.
Call your grandparents. Pick up the phone today. Give them a call.
We'll be back.